everyone. Today I thought that I would share my business story, how I went from £25 to business owner in less than 6 months. I've currently been running my brand Totes For You for 8 months now, and this is just going to be the full story of how it's grown from £25 to turning over 5 figures a month. It makes most sense to start back right at the beginning when I first decided to start. In the first lockdown, I had just finished my A-levels. Well, we were doing like online school for a bit. I was working in a supermarket, so I was counted as a key worker. And I was really bored in my spare time. And I had an idea to start embroidering. And I was like, what can I embroider? And then it just came to me, tote bags. I absolutely love tote bags, but I couldn't find any that I loved, like that I really wanted to go out and buy. So I thought, you know what, I'm gonna create my perfect tote bag. And then from there I was like, maybe people will like this. So I started a series on TikTok where I basically just shared the journey with everyone, and it went down well, better than I expected. As I said, I started to document the process from literally getting the idea, creating the ideas, to getting all of the materials, to starting the website. Everything is documented on TikTok. If you want to go right back, you can literally see when I'm like shy on camera and all of that stuff. I had no idea how to run a business, let alone a successful business. I knew the basics, that you should be making more money than you're spending, and that was about it. I did business GCSE. Maybe it helped a tiny bit, but to be honest, I don't really think it did much. I did what anybody else would do. I started creating designs, because obviously that's the first thing you need to do, find inspiration, create designs. And then I just did research, expanded my knowledge, just looked into stuff. At that time that I was doing all of that, I was not thinking I would end up here. I was just looking in the short future. Like, I wasn't thinking that I was gonna end up quitting my job later on down the line. Yeah, like I said, the first few videos did better than I could have expected. I didn't really expect them to get many views, maybe like a couple thousand, but the first video got about 65,000. It's on a lot more now, but within like the first week it got 65,000, and I was like, oh, like people are seeing this, people are liking it. And from people liking it, it just made me want to do it more and more. So like I said, started with £25 that I actually got from my granny, and I was like, I can't lose. I didn't even think she was gonna give me money, so I'm gonna use this, and it's something to do in lockdown. I bought needles, an embroidery hoop, embroidery thread, and tote bags for £25, all of Amazon. Since then, obviously, I've changed my suppliers, I've done a lot more research, but for the first initial tote bags, it was Amazon. It was all I knew. From there, I just started hand embroidering. Now, people ask if I had much experience embroidering, and the truth is, when I was about 10, 11, I was really into sewing, really into all of that sort of stuff. And then when I was like 14, 15, 16, didn't really do much of that stuff, but I still had the skills to do it, if that makes sense. So it came quite naturally to me when I started to do it. Also, I'm very much a perfectionist, so if I couldn't do it, I was gonna work until I could do it. Each one would take me about 1 to 3 hours, but I had the time. There was nothing else to do in lockdown, so embroidering totes was the thing that I did. I continued to document the whole process, and in the second month of posting, I had 5 million views in a month, which was crazy to me. The reach on TikTok is insane, and it's a platform that shouldn't go unnoticed. So I just couldn't believe it at this point. I was like, we've got something good here. I just wanted to continue it, make it keep on growing. And then I had my first Depop launch. Now, I decided to go on to Depop because there's no initial startup fees. You pay a fee on what you sell, but other than that, there's no other fees. And that drop sold out within 2 minutes. So at that point, I was like, okay, we've got something good here. Let's just continue it. After that, I did a few more drops on Depop, got 5-star reviews. I was like, I am enjoying this so much. This is so good. I was still working at Waitrose at this time, so I was only working 1 day a week, but I would do some overtime, and then the rest of the time was spent on the business, or, I mean, just going on walks, basically. After that, I asked my best friend Tanisha if she would model some tote bags for me because I wanted to start a website. Again, had no idea how to set a website, had no idea about the fees. Obviously, I knew it would cost money, I just didn't really know much about it. Photos came out really nice, if I do say so myself. I did take A-level photography, so I sort of had some skill in taking photos, and I really enjoy photography, so I used my A-level well there. At the end of June, it became pretty obvious that I couldn't hand embroider all of these totes that people wanted, so I decided it was time to get a machine. I bought a secondhand machine off one of our family friends from the profits that I'd made, and it was a lot cheaper than buying a new machine outright. It was such a good idea. I'm so lucky that she had one that she was selling. So yeah, that basically went in my favour, but I got an embroidery machine. As I said, the embroidery machine changed the game. I could now make totes a lot faster. I could do it in 10 minutes, whereas before it was 2 hours. And for me, branding throughout was key. From the start, branding was really important to me. I focused on imagery and packaging and then all of the social medias to just get the brand out there. So at the end of June, I decided that I would move away from Depop and I would create my own website. So I started the website totesforyouu.com. That launched on June the 25th, which seems so long ago now, but it was honestly the best decision. That day when we launched, I made 13 sales. So it wasn't anything crazy. Like, everything came with time, but we got 13 sales and I was so happy. I was buzzing. July was obviously our first full month on the website, running everything through there. And we made around £4,000. For me, I had never seen money like that come in. To put it into perspective for you guys, I worked for a year at Waitrose and I didn't even make £4,000 in that year, let alone £4,000 in a month. Now, that was sales, it wasn't profit, but even then it was crazy to me. After the website launched, I continued to do what I was doing because I knew that it worked. I would post every single day on TikTok. I would try to update my Instagram stories every day. I just continued to grow the socials. After that, the next step was that I started to ship internationally. Now, I didn't start off by doing this because I didn't really know how it worked. Once again, I was new to everything. But it was a lot easier than I thought, so I started to ship internationally as well. And then in August, we had 71,000 followers on TikTok, and we'd had about 300 orders at that point, which I was so happy with. Again, continued to make content, new designs. And then in September, I quit my supermarket job, which meant so much to me. I think it really was to me a mark of what I'd achieved, because I can't lie, I didn't enjoy working in a supermarket. I absolutely love what I do now, and the supermarket, I loved everybody that worked there. I just didn't like stacking shelves for 8 hours and not getting to talk to many people, and I just had too many ideas for that. In October, I hit 100k, which was a massive achievement for me. Something that I didn't even think I was going to achieve at the start of the year. And sales just continued to grow and grow after that, especially towards Christmas. All small business owners will tell you that sales always go up at Christmas because people are obviously buying presents for people. And at this point, I really started to reinvest my money back into the business. I started to buy things to make my life a lot easier. So I bought another embroidery machine. You can probably see behind me, I've got two. That one I bought brand new, which was a lot of money out of my pocket. I also got myself a label printer. I got the Dymo label printer 2XL. I think it's around £200. Again, a lot of money. But I was happy to invest at that point because I could really see where it was going. So around November, December time, I launched my sweatshirts, Real is Rare, and I did photo shoots with two of my best friends to promote them. And they went down really well. I didn't really know what to expect. I didn't order a lot because I was worried that maybe they wouldn't sell. It was something new, it was a new product, and Since the beginning, I'd only been selling totes, so to go into selling sweatshirts as well was a big jump for me. In December, I came out with some new notebooks I designed myself, which also went down really well. They're not our best-selling product, but they sold well for a new product at that time. Myself, a heat press, which meant that I could do more designs and I could add more designs to new things. It was just another way to expand our product range. After Christmas was over and everybody had been getting presents for people, I was expecting sales to drop, but they didn't, which really surprised me. I was fully prepared to, you know, have a drop in sales. Most small businesses will tell you that after Christmas their sales will drop dramatically. I decided to create a new product. I created our CEO of My Life daily planners and weekly planners, and I also sold them in a set for a lower price. These were so popular. Because they were a new product, I wasn't too sure how it was gonna go, but they sold out, I wanna say, within a day. Maybe it was a day or two, they'd sold out, and then I ended up buying more and putting them on pre-order, and since then they've sold pretty consistently. During this time I continued to get better and upgrade packaging, just focusing on the brand image and the idea that people had in their mind of the brand. Then I also released prints, which I was so excited about. I have loved decor and prints and stuff like that since basically forever. Since I can remember, I have always been obsessed with like decorating my room or just like that sort of thing. I made prints. I found somewhere that could print them for me. Again, they sold really well, kind of as I expected, slightly better. We can see a theme here. They always sell a bit better than I think. In January, I also decided to turn the back room in our house into my office. It's basically a room in our house that wasn't really being used for anything, and I was getting way too much stock in. There was just no space for anything. So I decided that I would turn a room into my office. This behind me is still my bedroom. It's still where I make totes, but downstairs I have the heat press. I have all of the products that don't need to be made, and then I also have a lot of tote bags down there as well, just because it's a lot more space, it's got a lot more room. I renovated that room. I ended up painting it, we got a new floor, and then I just decorated it how I'd like. Then I dropped probably the most exciting collection that I've ever produced, in my opinion. It was my favorite collection, still is, and that is the Better Days Ahead collection. Now, this meant so much to me. I came up with the idea, I came up with the idea in December sort of time. I remember that I posted the quote that I created to Instagram, and it got so many saves, it got so many shares, and I was like, people really like this, and I thought it was a message that just needed to be spread everywhere. So after that I was like, okay, I'm gonna make products with this quote on. Now this was risky. I even remember my dad said, are people gonna buy things with like that much text on the back of a hoodie? And I was like, I think they will. I always go with my gut, and I also go with what I would wear, and this was something that I still love wearing. Like, any chance I get, I wear this hoodie. They sold out within minutes. I have never had so many people on the website preparing to buy one, and so many people were disappointed, and I just couldn't believe it. I wasn't expecting them to sell out. That day that there was the drop of the collection, we had our biggest day of sales. We turned over 4.4k in just the day. So we went from the first month turning over 4k to turning over 4k in a day, which, just as you can tell, still is crazy to me. So now day to day I get between 6 to 30 orders, just depending on the day. Sometimes a video is done a bit better. Generally on a launch or a restock we will sell a lot more than that, but on average, that's how much we sell a day. So that is an insight on how I grew my business from £25 to where it is now, turning over five figures a month. If you did enjoy this video, please don't forget to subscribe and like. I'm going to be making so much more business content, whether you want to start a business yourself, you're interested in Totes For You and how I started it, or you just love the vlogs. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all soon. Hi, it's me again. Don't forget that we also have a TikTok, Totes For You, and Instagram. If you want to see any more behind the scenes, head over there and give us a follow and say hi.